We are live right now. It is the New Music Show Online, a.k.a. The Weekend Mixtape. I am DJ Ski, joined by Julie Pilot.
I am so excited about our artist today. I really am.
You're glowing.
And, you know, it's funny. She came in, and I had, like, 100 questions for Kreayshawn that I wanted to ask her, but I thought I would save it for this.
Why not?
Yeah.
Stuff is crazy. She actually came on this show when we first started doing the Weekend Mixtape in your office.
I mean, it's a historic day. This is the first artist in a year and a half that we've ever had on twice.
Yeah, so she was on originally, now is back. And it's crazy because she's had so much success in that time and still hasn't dropped her debut album, which she's about to. So it's
gonna
be fun.
That's a really good point. I mean, seriously, I don't know if you guys know this, but we started doing the New Music Show because we would always make a mixtape every week of all the new music, and Ski gets everything first.
I try.
So I had a standing meeting that he'd meet with me in my office. We'd make the mixtape. Everybody in the building wanted one. And so all these people would be hanging out in the office. We'd be talking music, and we decided to live stream it.
Yeah.
And it grew from Wayne's World style, like a bunch of people just sitting around my office.
And once we, that's pretty bad. And once we started getting some bands in there, it didn't smell that good a lot of times. So I felt bad for Julie
Speak
all day.
Speak for yourself.
So now we moved it in here. Now we have a whole audience full of, this is packed today. This is as packed as it's ever been. Thank you guys for coming out.
Yes.
Absolutely.
And we have live performances just about every single week.
Crazy.
And if anybody ever wants to check out the music we're talking about, our digital team gets it all on the Weekend Mixtape blog, so you can be in the know before all your friends about what's hot, what's new music.
And you can tune in Sunday nights to the New Music Show, where we play pretty much all the songs that we talk about on here, too, and have other cool interviews. So,
on that note, what do you got for new music this week?
New music. I'm going to keep it in the Bay Area since Kreayshawn is here. So Lover Ant's had a record called Up that climbed to the charts, but he has another single that's about to come out that's pretty crazy. It features Tyga. It's called Act Up. The beat is nuts. I think it's going to be a club banger for the fall and be a huge record. So we're actually going to premiere it, I think, on our blog and this weekend on the New Music Show. So check it out. Shout out to Lover Ants.
Speaking of world premieres, for those of you watching the live stream, I can't put it up today, but we will get it up very soon by the end of the week. New Enrique Iglesias is coming.
And he's been killing it recently.
Yeah, it features Sammy Adams. So it's called Finally Found You, and you'll be hearing it very soon if you're listening to Kiss.
Great.
And we'll get it on the blog as soon as we can.
Killer.
Speaking of the Bay, we also have a special guest today with a music report.
Prophet. Exactly. It's only right.
From Seven Lions.
Makes a noise for Prof.
What's up?
Yo, what up, what up, what up, what up? Music is crazy. This morning, I heard that LL Cool J had a Mama Said Knock You Out morning for real by handling a burglar that went in his crib by himself. So I thought that was crazy. I read that this morning. Nuts, right? And
he literally knocked the dude out.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. I don't want to put that out there. He might get indicted, but it definitely was not his breakfast call. You know,
he lives here, right?
Yeah, LA and New York, I think.
It's crazy.
Another crazy thing is J-Lo may have left Idol, but I think she might be doing her thing in Vegas right now. She may have a residency coming up. So.
That's crazy. And I heard Nicki Minaj might be taking her place.
Yeah, crazy, right? And then she, I guess somebody else tweeted out that they wanted Lenny Kravitz or something. Like,
I really hope no matter what they keep Randy Jackson on there, right?
He's the only dude that hasn't been getting shuffled, though. You know?
I don't know. I heard he might just be a consultant now, they're saying. So we'll see.
That would be so sad after all these years. Randy Jackson would rep for Mariah so hard every single time somebody covered a Mariah song. Then the year she's actually a judge, he's not there. That can't happen.
Nuts. I don't think it'd happen. But if you guys were looking for something to do this weekend, I know we got something crazy popping off at the Strand at Huntington Beach. My band, Seven Lions, is going to be out there, and I'm really stoked to see Austin Brown, who is our good friend, who I have not seen live yet, and he's crazy. Check him out. Google him. You'll see the video. You'll know what I'm talking about.
Good video. Austin Brown and the Backpack Kids.
Nice.
Free concert. If you guys want to go to the beach, really kind of like one of the last weekends of summer, that's going on Saturday between 4 and 7 at the Strand in Huntington Beach.
It's going to be killer.
Style, y'all.
Seven Lions.
Yay.
Prof,
thanks,
thank
Prof.
You. Yes. Now, should we get to the moment they've all been waiting for?
Yeah, let's do it.
All right, make some noise if you want to see Kreayshawn.
She's got the gloves.
Great, she got the gloves. Dizzy.
What's it like holding a mic with those gloves? Can you do that? Or are we going to share? Oh, here, Ski's got your mic.
Go. Should I just hold it up for you? Will that be?
I'm going to attempt.
All right.
Hello?
There we go.
I can't believe I'm waiting.
So, Kreayshawn, first of all, something you need to know about me, I'm the worst liar in the world. I can't lie about anything. Mm-hmm. And she came in the building, and she looked at me, and she goes, do you still have my business card?
And she lied, but she didn't lie.
Yeah, you did I just got uncomfortable.
Yeah, you were just like,
maybe. But no, of course, I've had this. You guys got to zoom in on this. I've had this hanging up in my office.
We've been talking about this for if people watch the show too for like 6 months. So yeah.
It's Kreayshawn's business card. I hate to flip over.
Oh, you can. That email don't work no more.
Okay, so you can see what she did was, first of all, like, I got to tell the story how we even ran into you. We were doing the weekend mixtape, mm-hmm. and every single week when we're talking about new music, you can do the hashtag weekend mixtape, and I always check to see what new music people are buzzing about. And all these people are like, yo, you got to check out this girl, Kreayshawn from the Bay. So I got excited about it. I listened to it, and then I was talking to another friend, mm-hmm. and they said, there's this artist, she's meeting with every record label. Everybody's buzzing about her. You should hear her music. And I said, you know what? I would love to meet her. She's more than welcome to come in. And this music biz is so crazy. If she ever wants to come to Kiss just to like talk about anything, she's more than welcome. So you came in.
I came.
And you gave me your business card. Explain to people what the deal
is. It's so amazing.
I basically like found in the trash can like a family who threw out all their like family photos and like all their class picture wallet size things. So wow. I like found it and I got a typewriter and typed my information on the back of every card with a personal message or message.
That's incredible.
And so how unique is this? Is this like this one says, of 24?
This one says Brad plus Jennifer, and it was probably one of 50.
Wow. What did you Limited. Ever did anybody ever find out who this family was or track
no.
them down?
No.
They weren't tagged be like on Facebook.
But there is more limited pictures than this one. There's actually one with his face fading away into black abyss, and he's like, and then his sister's like this.
I wasn't 100% sure that was a dude. I thought it could have been like, damn. You know, an awkward.
I look grade. Like this. I hate when I give this to people. I used to give this to people. Like, oh my God, that's you? And I'm like, what? No?
What do you think happened to that family to make them throw out all those cards?
I feel like it was a know. Mom. It was a mom who their kids went to college, mm-hmm. and she was just sad.
So you throw away all your family?
I was going to go if they got retakes. Remember when you could like opt in for if your picture sucked?
My story is just
It's true.
So, but your real story is pretty incredible because we went from getting that business card that day to like 2 weeks later, it went from, oh, you should meet this girl. She's welcome to come in. We'll help her out, to signing a big, gigantic record label deal.
Yeah.
And then like 2 weeks after that, I hear you're directing the Red Hot Chili Peppers video. And it was one of those moments where I was like,
I was doing this.
What
same
is
thing.
Going on?
Yeah,
in
me
world?
Too. What is going on? No. So, but yeah, it was crazy to go on that little adventure right there so quick, from like doing my dream of directing big budget videos to making music for everyone in the world all in 1 month.
Right. What have you been doing the last year?
I've been doing a lot of tours because, you know, like I came out with Gucci Gucci and like no one really got to see me perform live before that. So it was kind of like addressing the world and letting them know that I'm here for them. And then so I toured doing that, and then I worked on the album, and that was...
And it's crazy because you've had this big career already and you haven't even dropped your album officially yet.
Yeah.
Like, it seems like you know, it would have come from now. What's it been like, you know, waiting to actually put the full product out?
It was fun. Like, I got, you know, a couple months off to work on it, which That's was good. Exciting, and finding the right people to work mm-hmm. with. And then once you find the right people, it kind of just, like, flies out of you.
Yeah.
And, you know, now I've just been waiting for it to come out. We've been done with it for a second, but you gotta do the album artwork and all it's crazy to see how different like what an album takes to opposed to a mixtape is like.
It's a little bit different work.
It's intense, yeah.
Yeah, what was it like going from, you know, doing everything yourself to having like unlimited resources and a full team? Easier or harder than
harder.
You thought?
It's harder. It's harder just because like, you know, you don't want to, I don't know, like it's your ideas and then like everyone kind of has to like weigh in on it, so then like it becomes like a group thing. But I think it sounds better when it's a group thing, you know, because then I don't know, it's less like me being a weirdo and me being more for everyone. Even though I'm still a weirdo.
Now the video is crazy too for the joint Go Hard that you're going to perform in a second. You directed that one too, right?
Yeah, I wrote the treatment for it, but I had a co-director.
Okay, how do you get down and do it all from coming up with the just making the record, then coming with the concept for the video, then actually shooting the video and directing yourself, like co-directing yourself this time? How do you balance so many different things at once?
It's really difficult. I go like literally insane all the time.
Sure.
Like, people follow me on Twitter, they're like, usually think I'm like suicidal or something because I just say really vague poetic things. But it's definitely hard to do everything. And then at the same time, like with the team of people you work with, you're still like always denying ideas. Yeah. And sometimes like with La La La, I kind of let the video like go in the hands of somebody. Yeah. Which ended up being like the best idea because I was having such a blast on that video shoot.
That's great.
You know, I wasn't all stressed out like crazy.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
I don't know if this sounds crazy, but we were talking about you coming in this week and people are getting all excited, and I said everybody's got a little Kreayshawn in them.
They do.
And now how would you define that?
I would just define that as people who listen to my music, they have the kind of like, it's not like I don't give a fuck about anything, but it's like the I don't give a fuck what people think about me. Mm-hmm. and like the confidence. And I think that's what got me this far, is like my confidence. And I think when people listen to my music, they get like a little bit of that confidence in them, you know?
It's Cray.
It's Cray. Literally. Crayism. Christianity.
Okay, I have one more question for you. I know some people want to see you perform, but we were talking about it a little bit in the hallway. You know, just as far as advice for new artists, we were talking about the Bay. There's so much talent in the Bay, and it seems like a lot of people feel they need to move to L.A., and that was probably, since the Bay is such a huge part of your identity, a big move for you.
Yeah.
You know, is it something you think you had to do to make it? And what advice do you have for people?
I initially moved out to LA to be a grip on movie sets. Like, that was my dream. Wow. I was like, I'm going to be a grip on a movie set, and then I'm going to work my way up, and then I'm going to be a director, and then blah, blah, blah. And so, like, it's interesting to see that L.A. is such, like, a mecca for music that, like, you know, you can get discovered while not even, like, trying to get discovered. I guess I was trying to get to. I don't even know.
It just works itself out.
Yeah,
somehow.
It all happens. And I think, you know, it's important for artists to follow their dreams, whether that means in your head or literally go move to L.A. and follow your dreams.
What have you not done that you want to do in this industry yet?
Like music wise,
anything wise, it could be direct.
I want to produce. I want to like learn how to make beats. I got like all these like crazy like like things to make beats and Electribes and stuff like that. And I can't.
You gotta get
them
in.
But maybe you can help me out.
Done deal. It's on a crackable Kreayski. It's going down.
Yeah.
I got a good idea.
Kreayski.
Why don't I get off the stage so you can jump behind the turntables and Kreayshawn can perform,
and I can do my performance.
Let's get it.
Hey, hey. Oh, I got kisses. You know, I don't have any money.
Hey, miss, do you really, really, really want to go hard? Go in the cribs, do you step on this credit card? And take the car, do circles in the parking lot. Scream at the top of our lungs like la la la. La 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 la
Now, I know some people in the audience wanted to ask some questions, too, and we're going to have some tickets to give away to your upcoming concert at the El Rey in December. So if anybody wants to ask a question, could you guys line up over here, and we'll get to that in a second. Tell us about your tour, though. I love it. It's the Group Hug Tour?
It's called the Group Hug Tour, and it's an all-female lineup.
I love Rai. She's on the road with you, right?
Her live show is going to be insane.
I mean, that's like ultimate dance party right there.
Yeah, it's me, Rai, Honey Cocaine, and Chippy Nonstop. So it's gonna be an all-girl fiesta. We're going to have some fun.
And it's December at the El Rey, so Merry Christmas awesome. To all of us.
Yeah.
How about another question from the live stream?
Tell us a little bit about your collab with Kid Cudi.
Okay. Everyone's ready for
Breaking
the Cudi.
News.
I know.
Everyone's ready for the Cudi track.
Yeah.
Well, we did a song, and like my whole album is inspired by different genres of music. And the song that we ended up getting on together that we did was a punk song or punk inspired song. So it's just interesting to have, like, you know, me and Cudi do such a like outrageously different track together, and we're both like really different type of artists, so I think us coming together on that sound is gonna be dope.
When's everybody gonna get to hear the full album?
September 18th.
Okay, cool. Say, anything else you want people to know before we wrap up?
Oh yeah, and I have tattoo of Mickey hands. These aren't mine.
I stole them from Disneyland.
I stole them from someone's desk. Who's not here? So she's
from our building.
Yes.
Oh, that'll go over.
She's
big.
Gonna be pissed tomorrow.
Between that and the
why
dog.
Why did you let Kreayshawn sweat? In
I better not be seen with these. Then,
but I just want to let everyone know that the album comes out September 18th, and the tour, Group Hug Tour, starts November 1st, and it's gonna be a big moment the next couple of months. So get ready, because you're gonna be hearing all about me. Something about Kray. Something about Kray.
Nice. Kreayshawn, thank you so much for taking the time out again and being our first guest to be up here twice on the Weekend Mixtape.
Thank you.
Making history. Ladies and gentlemen, Kreayshawn, you can, of course, log online to see this full interview, everything else. It's the Weekend Mixtape, a.k.a. the new music show online. It goes down every Wednesday, 3:30 live, then we post the videos up Fridays. And I'll come at you with the new music show Sunday nights. I'm DJ Ski.
I'm Julie Pilot. I hope to see all you guys back here again.
I'm Kreayshawn.
That's what I'm
See you guys later.
Peace.